Hey guys, I'm Mark, and today I want to show you a way that I use to store beets. Now you could use this method to store beets, carrots, any kind of tuberous or bulbous rooted vegetable. You can even do this with flowers like glads, dahlias, canna lilies, calla lilies, elephant ears, all that kind of stuff that's either got a bulbous root or a tuberous root. This method is going to work really well for that also. This is a great method to use, especially this time of year in late July, where there's a lot of things that are coming into season right now and refrigerator space is a little bit limited. I'm not going to use a refrigerator at all with how I'm going to store these guys. But it's basically accomplishes when you have enough of something that it's not gonna last more than a week or two. I mean, you wanna be able to pack it away so that it's good for a month or two or three, 4 months, and you can still enjoy it for that much longer. So behind me here, for today's sake, I'm gonna be using the example of beets. You can see I've got three rows of beets behind me. This is a Boro F1 hybrid beet. I'm a big fan of it. So far, this is the first year I've grown it. I'm really happy, especially for how it holds up in the heat. It hasn't gotten tough or fibrous. It's a really strong plant. It grew quickly. It's got a real nice flavor to it. And the tops are really nice too, as well. The tops make excellent greens. They're super healthy for you, almost as healthy as kale or spinach and all that kind of stuff. Excellent. I actually do like regular beet greens more than I like Swiss chard. But anyway, now it's time to pull up the roots. This is the first harvest, if you will, and the last thinning. So what I mean by that is these bulbs are just big enough now where they're about full size. This is about as big as I want them to get. I don't want them to get a whole lot larger than this. They start to get tough or woody. I can explain a little bit of that later. But these are about the perfect size for storage. And then I'm also getting the ones out that are just sort of crowded. If there's like three or four in a row, they're just kind of pressing up against each other and they're not really going to get any bigger because of that, then I'm going to yank those out also. After I yank them out, I'm going to get a big old pile together, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the tops off. You can save the tops if you want to, just cook them up, boil them like I was saying, or you can just feed them to the chickens or whatever you want to do. I'm sort of sick of eating beet greens by now, honestly. I'm just ready to get into the roasting aspect of things. But anyway, you cut the tops off. Do not cut the root off. I'm going to tell you why that is in a little while. And you also do not want to wash them with this particular way of storage. The film of soil that's on the exterior of the skin of this beet is actually going to help protect it a little bit with the way that I'm planning on storing these. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to pull these up. I'm going to put them in a bin just like that, a whole bunch of them. And then I'm actually going to take you down to the creek to show you how I store them. So I will see you down there. All right, guys, now I'm going to show you how to pack these beets away for storage. In my case, I'm going to pack them in sand. And I'm going to do that because, well, I have sand, number one. It's very accessible for me. Down here by the river, I've got a big pile of it right here next to me, and that was deposited here for free last year when the river jumped the bank. So I'm going to take advantage of having this. But you could use a couple different things. I mean, you could use sand, you could use sawdust, you could even use peat moss if you have it and it hasn't been like saturated with fertilizer or anything like that, if it's still inert. Sawdust works great, and that might even be more practical for you if you don't have a supply of sand on hand, because to go out and get, you know, you're not going to go out and get 80 pounds of sand just to store your beets and your carrots in, but sawdust might, you know, be a little bit easier to get your hands on. A lot of sawmills that are around, small sawmills here and there, you could pull up, and if you ask them real nicely, I'd almost guarantee they're going to say, yeah, go ahead, fill up a trash can, do whatever you want to do. It's a lot more lighter weight, just easier to work with, easier to carry around. But basically, the overall concept is that you don't want these beets or carrots to be making a whole lot of contact with each other or with the side of the box. It's basically like if you think about even herbs or lettuce that you would get, when you get it and you put it in a bag, almost always when it starts to rot, it's where it makes contact with the side of the plastic right there. It's like that little film of water that gathers. And where that little film of water is and it makes contact with any plant material, you're almost guaranteed to start to have some problems. So the sand effectively kind of just wicks away any moisture that's sitting anywhere, up against anything, down at the bottom. It wicks it away so that it doesn't have the chance to kind of just sort of sit there up against the plant material. So anyway, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna line the bottom of this box with a course of beets. You can see that I still have the roots on there. I did not cut the roots off, cut the tops off, but I didn't cut the roots off because if these beets want to pull in any moisture out of the surrounding sand while they're in storage, they can do that. In fact, if you go back a couple months from now or a few months from now and you go to pull these guys out, you'll see them start to send out little white roots off of that main stem and around the sides and stuff. And same thing with the carrots. So leaving the roots on just allows them to do that. But I've already got an inch of sand at the bottom of this box. And I'm just packing them in here. I mean, I'm packing them in fairly tight. These are round. In the case of carrots, if you were stacking them, you give them a little bit more space because carrots are long and there'd be a lot more surface area for them to make contact with one another, sort of like how you'd stack pencils kind of. But these are like round balls. So, you know, they can, if they are making contact with one another, it's only by like a little tiny bit. And the sand in this case is going to fall in between. And, you know, there's not going to be much, you know, of them being too close together and touching too much going on. But basically just going to layer them in like this. These are a great size for storage, is a great size for harvesting in general, I find, for beets. I don't like my beets to get too big. I'd say baseball size is where I would call it a day. I wouldn't like to let them get too much bigger than that. Depending upon the variety too, that has a lot to do with it. Some varieties will get a little bit more woody. They'll get a little more fibrous as they get bigger. These are Boro F1s. Even some of the larger ones are still nice and tender. But then also something for the size of your beets too that you want to pay attention to is the time of year, because if it's still in a cooler time of year where the beets are actively growing a whole lot faster, then you can get away with them getting to a larger size and still not becoming as fibrous or tough as they would in a hotter summer situation where they're a little bit more stressed out. Anyways, there's one layer. I've got them packed in pretty tight. You can see I'm going to try to lift this as far as I can get without dumping them. You can see they're you know, they're just in there. But now I'm gonna put another layer of sand right on top. And I will, that was like just perfect. And I will layer another row in and then another layer of sand, same thing. And then another layer on top of that. And I'll get three courses in here before I finally cap it off with this final layer of sand. And that'll be enough to fill this box. It'll still be manageable enough to carry even with sand in it. If you're storing your stuff in sawdust, you could probably use a bin that's a little bit larger than this and it'll still be, you know, you'll still be able to pick it up relatively easily. But that's how I'm going to store these beets. I'm going to keep them in here. I'm going to cap it off and I'm going to put it in one of our garages that is air conditioned and has, boy, it sounds like Holly's chewing up a bottle. It sounded like a tree was falling. Anyway, I'm going to put them in an air-conditioned garage on a cement floor. That garage stays about somewhere in the high 60s. So when they're making contact with the cement floor, it's going to be a real nice way to keep these guys cool because they're filled with sand, and sand is a nice... What do you have? Come here. Come here. Holly, come here. Come on. Let me see. She's not going to come. But anyway, the sand creates a nice thermal sink. It's really nice and heavy, that is going to be one benefit of using sand over sawdust. I forgot to mention that, is that sand, it's going to lock on to that cooler temperature. The temperature is not going to fluctuate up and down relatively as much as it would if you pack these guys in sawdust, if that makes any sense. But anyway, that is my video on how to store roots, beets, carrots, tuberous begonias, canna bulbs, calla lily bulbs, a lot of different things can be stored this way, especially over the winter time. And you're going to come out on the other side of winter, in the case if you're going to replant these again that much further ahead. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching my video. If you have not subscribed yet, please do, because that helps with the YouTube algorithm. It bumps my video up in the scheme of things and it gets in front of more eyes. So your subscription helps me out more than you'd think. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.